So I don't know what the big deal is. Like, they can look wherever they want to. It doesn't really matter, does it?
No. Put yourself in their shoes, right? See the situation. It's a corridor, right? And there's nothing, there's no window on the left. There's nothing to look at, right? Okay. It's just two empty walls. So what are you going to do?
It's a really dull place. No painting, nothing.
See, the author doesn't say that, but let's assume that. Let's assume bare walls, nothing to look at.
Okay, so they can do one thing. They can, at first, by far itself, they can acknowledge each other. Like, they can say hi to each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just walk by. Just move on.
No, see, that's exactly what he's trying to focus on. You see someone from a distance, right?
Okay.
And remember, KNL, then they're not friends. They're, let's say they're classmates, right? They just know each other, acquaintances. So there's an obligation to say hi, but again, they're not very comfortable with each other, right?
Yeah.
And let's say they're, this distance is 15 meters, right?
Okay.
They're this far away from each other. So you say hi initially, like you said. What are you going to do for this time?
They can look wherever, like, they can look anywhere. You can look down, do something, just move forward.
Isn't that quite awkward and a bit rude as well? Because you've said hi, so you've acknowledged okay. This person is there, but now you're looking away, and so your body language is saying, at one moment you said, you know, you're there, and you're ignoring him for the rest of the time. Isn't that quite uncomfortable?
Of course, the situation is uncomfortable. Like, what do we do about it?
Well, see why and try to resolve it. For example, I'm uncomfortable with paper cups.
Yeah, right? I mean, these, it's really soggy and it tastes weird also, right?
Sure. And, well, then it's not very good for the environment either.
Okay.
So, we can go get melamine cups, right? We can ask someone for melamine.
Melamine cups are better.
Right, like, and resolve the situation. Right?
Yeah, there's this clinging sound. My mom also like that. So...
But wouldn't it be rude if you just pass by and don't look at their faces?
Sure. So what would you do?
Maybe smile at them.
Smile when exactly?
Like, for how long can you smile?
It's actually between whether you want to be creepy or awkward or maybe rude, I guess. So if you smile, it might appear to be creepy, but still.
Are those your only options? Do you agree? I mean, is the situation that hopeless? See, you either got to be creepy or rude or unpleasant.
It doesn't have to be like that. It's, of course, it's going to be a little awkward. This happens to us every day, you know? So, and we don't always go deep into that awkward part. We just move on. It's kind of normal,
that,
right?
That, in a sense, that's what the author's trying to do. He's trying to go into that situation, trying to identify what's making it so awkward.
Yeah, so what do we do? So we... I gave you a suggestion. They acknowledge each other from a distance. Now, you said something about smiling, right?
Yeah, maybe just say hi. I'll just make a conversation.
Right, but how long can you smile for? I mean, they're quite 15 meters away, right? And, like, there's quite some time for them to go. So, can they smile all the way?
Maybe smile at the beginning and close again, smile once more.
Right, but in that time, till you reach
it's
close by to the...
It's 15 seconds, right?
Right, but 15 seconds can feel like a long time. It could feel like 15 minutes in an awkward scenario, right?
Yeah, it's kind of true because this tea bag's been in my tea for the last 15 minutes and nothing's happening.
Yeah, like, this is so distracting. Like, why?
Maybe it does not even taste natural.
Yeah, I mean, still.
What I think is that both K and L should be true to what they feel like. I mean, they should be really natural. Don't you think so, Professor?
Well, do you really think it's a question of being natural? In this scenario, it's just a simple obligation, right, of saying hi.
I mean, if one of them wants to just greet, let them greet. Or even if just one wants to look down and just walk past through other, let's
okay,
just
but
do it.
Just take a moment and, you know, be like, look at it from K's perspective. What do I do with my hands, with my face, with my body in this time as I'm approaching it? How do I as K be true to myself?
It's a matter of 15 seconds, right? I mean, if one of them is feeling awkward, let them feel awkward. I mean, it's just one of the human feelings, right?
Okay, but isn't awkwardness a unpleasant feeling? Isn't it something you'd want to solve?
In some situations, it's kind of normal to be awkward.
But wouldn't the world generally be better if you just could have this another way? Because you'd agree that both, all of us have this experience, right? Right. So it's common to all of us. So maybe there's something we can do to solve it. Okay, I'll give you another scenario to the problem, right? Suppose K is walking, he sees L and he decides, okay, let's pretend as if this person isn't there. And when I reach, then, you know, oh, hi, right? Pretend as if you're seeing him for the first time, right? What if L, from a distance, itself shouts out, hi? Yeah, makes it all the more awkward. What would you do then? Now you still got this gap of 15 meters. What are you going to do?
This chai is too sweet for me.
I mean, don't you think that would be unnecessary obligation? I mean, if the person has to look somewhere and the person doesn't want to. But okay. You know, when you're on a social level, you follow some of the society norms and ethics, right? Saying hi doesn't do any bad to you.
I mean, what if in the first place the person was not there at all? I would have looked straight and walked straight. Now why do I need to bend my way of looking or way of walking?
No, it's going to be a reflex, right? When somebody says hi to you, you say hi back.
Right, it's almost involuntary. It's out of your control almost. You have to acknowledge the person.
I mean, it might depend upon your mood maybe. If you're happy, you might react in a particular way. If you're not happy, you might depend.
Ideally and normally, you would respond in some way. If not say hi, you'll at least nod or smile or something at the very least.
I mean, what I think is that maybe personal space is something that comes first. And then the society norms, I mean, if I'm not comfortable with saying hi to somebody, then why should I say it at all?
I mean, then how would somebody ever talk to you for the first time?
So if you don't say hi to anyone, what if they don't hi back to you when you want to greet? You can't carry this personal space bubble with you everywhere.
I mean, don't you think there should be maybe a sort of universal law about it?
I don't think there should be any answer. I don't follow.
Read and understood, right? But it's also a separate question, right? Maybe we can keep that debate for later. Come back to this issue. Not so much a thing of individual right versus social good, but think of it from the perspective of K. And how is K seeing it? How do you deal with this scenario? These 15 odd seconds of awkwardness?
Don't you think that we can have maybe a universal law about it?
But like, I'm thinking in other perspective.
I don't think there should be a universal law. I don't follow it. You can't be. I mean, there is some validity to universal law. What do you think? I mean, because everyone experiences this. Yeah, so I mean, everyone is different, so how can we have a uniform universal law for everyone?
What if the law is about maybe differences and sort of accommodating the differences? But that makes no sense.
Right.
I mean,
essentially, like, and look at it, assume now instead of K, you look at it from L's perspective. Right? It's the same thing. It's the same question of how do I react? How do I do it? Right? So, I mean, if everyone goes through the experience, surely there's some common ground on which we can solve this issue, right?
But a law again changes your right
process. Sure. So, by law, it's more like a code, a mechanism by which you can deal with awkwardness. Right? There's some agreed upon conditions that this is how you deal with the situation.
Is it that weird? Is it that awkward?
Yeah.
And you tell me.
Yeah, we are going through this every day.
Sure.
It is normal.
Don't you think doing something out of our own bound will make us look really creepy?
It will make it more awkward.
Actually, yeah.
By talking about it, it's more awkward.
Do you think so? So that's an excellent point, because the author considers that, like, towards the end, right? By highlighting this issue that everyone goes through silently without talking about.
I mean, my point is, why do we even need to have a conversation regarding this problem? I mean, why is it even important?
Simply because it's a problem. Simply because it's...